More redundant formula for the treatment. Our cross examination and what some are calling a second granulation, which I'm concerned my client admitted, it was longer than
that. You know for a fact, don't you, that Dr. Murray has gone for longer than 2 minutes? No, no. Have you heard any of the phone calls that he's been made?
He could have made, I heard about the phone calls. I don't comment on the phone calls because I only took his words.
Okay.
So yeah. I don't comment. You should mind if you're telling me he was on the phone, you're giving me that information. He shouldn't have been on the phone. And it just tells me that maybe he wasn't a perfect quality user because you can't talk on the phone when someone just got 25 football ball. Why would I talk on the phone? I'd wait to use the exact same up.
So what is the defense trying to get at?
Right? Yeah.
Someone has used it there.
Yeah, and I think the doctor came off. You know, they're talking with this one that probably came off pretty smart, either. Yet, listening to that experience right now, seems like a likable, affable, reasonable guy. Reasonable speaker. I think what's happening is, see, the doctor was given a hypothetical. Part of the process of insurance, so, assume that everything happened just the way the statement of Dr. Murray's mother was treasured to the left. We still don't know how to do that. And I find him saying, the one thing is more than 2 minutes. And I think that's because of the defense expects that the testimony that will be most credible will say that he was gone for more than 2 minutes. And so they have to be able to say, look, he was gone for more than 2 minutes, didn't necessarily do something wrong. They're trying to get the doctor to know it. He could have been, he was gone for more than 2 minutes, he still could have been doing something medically reasonable and non-medical.
And so the sentence match continues, and the prosecutor gave the law to that, Dr. Samuels, and the official judgment about Tom Redmore, even if he's been trying to sue the doctor, he's not going to be himself to throw the food.
All the masses, he would be able to do Dr. Murray's own work. For the sake of argument, let's assume that all transpired to Michael Jackson, who then self-administered either the Rabbit Camera protocol because it was not being monitored appropriately by his doctors.
Come on!
So, Dr. Murray still being directly responsible for the